You're not just in a car. Your combined weight is a deadly weapon.
It's May this year in central Queensland. Driving conditions are perfect, but then suddenly...
My thoughts were, oh, shit.
Careful. Oh, shit. Don't brake. Oh, you OK?
Yeah, I'm OK.
So am I.
What happened?
Upside down and trapped inside are two 73-year-old retirees, driver Jim Ennis and passenger Steve McClung.
Push up if you can with your knees, airbags, the whole thing.
Every time you see the wreck of particularly a caravan, your stomach drops. You try and wonder or try and figure out what they did, what they were doing. When a caravan wrecks, it wrecks.
On the roads and highways around Australia this year, it's been caravan carnage. Large vans that are simply too unstable on the road, either because they're too heavy or the weight inside them has not been distributed evenly.
And you've also got the car and caravan hurtling down the road, which can be 5 tonne plus. I do have concerns about more lives being lost of caravanners.
Jim and Steve from Newcastle were on a boys' own adventure, taking their $100,000 Toyota Land Cruiser and $100,000 Kedron Caravan on a 10-week trip around Queensland. When it came to safe towing, they certainly knew the basics.
Not excessive speeds at any time. Even on motorways, we would always try and keep to 90. I think towing is just a case of common sense. And we did do the course in the very beginning. We learnt how to effectively load the van.
But despite all their precautions, things came unstuck near Charleville.
He began to drift towards the left. Once we got into that fishtail effect, we were trained to hit the accelerator when that happens. The problem is that your brain doesn't think that way in an emergency.
Careful. Oh, shit. Don't brake! Oh, you OK?
My thoughts were, well, this is it. This is how life is going to end.
To think that we walked away from that.
Jim was standing there in something of a daze and sort of turned to me and said, who was driving? And that was a shock.
Yes. I really had no concept of what had happened. Why do I think the accident happened? I honestly cannot answer that question.
8 weeks before Jim and Steve's crash, this horrifying scene confronted police near the small town of Harvey in Western Australia. A four-wheel drive and a fully loaded caravan with an elderly couple trapped inside.
Push that seatbelt in for me, please.
Quickly, sir.
Come on, man.
So glad to see you alive.
Seconds after being pulled from the wreckage, the van's gas bottles exploded. The spike in crashes is perhaps a direct result of this, a caravan craze that's been sweeping the country. Wait times for some vans can top 2 years.
It was busy prior to COVID, but now it's just spurred on tenfold.
This is the Queensland Caravan Super Show. Forget your grandparents' old box on wheels. These caravans are more like a small luxury apartment and can cost anywhere up to $200,000.
TVs, inverters, twin slide-outs, galley-style kitchen, Italian leather. Everything we can do to the best, this has it.
There's over 200 companies represented here, showcasing thousands of caravans. And tucked away in one dimly lit corner is this man.
Even that back corner of the caravan, you've still got to be able to see that.
Sergeant Brett Vincent from Queensland Police, whose job it is to educate the caravanning public.
I'm a caravaner myself, that's why I'm down here.
Brett cites uneven weight distribution as the major reason why there are so many caravan crashes.
Whether that's a weight issue in relation to the tow vehicle, whether it be tail heavy, front light, or weight issue in relation to the caravan itself, the caravan could be way over its legal weight limit, or even the tow vehicle might be way over its legal weight limit.
And there's a right and wrong way to load your caravan.
In a caravan, you definitely don't want to be putting heavy items up high. You want to keep them down low over the axles, preferably. You don't want a lot of heavy weight behind the axles, and you don't want a lot of heavy weight too far forward of the axles. me personally, I'd like to see a licence introduced and an actual practical test for people so they feel confident behind the wheel, towing the caravan, and also not only towing the caravan forward, but also reversing. Yeah, so you've got to have a licence for a motorcycle, boat, jet ski, car, light rigid truck, heavy rigid truck, everything else, everything except towing.
Now back in Newcastle, Jim and Steve are taking life in the slow lane. Happy to be off the road for the time being.
To be honest with you, it has put me off driving. Material things, possessions can be replaced. Lives can't. And that probably is the main thought that's come away from the whole experience, is I could have easily been responsible for the death of my friend.
Wow. Oh, wow. There goes my grey nomad dreams right there.
Well, I think it's a great way to see the country. I have a caravan and I must say my wife does most of the driving on it, but she's been educated on it, so she knows it's really important you do the course. So she does, and she knows about weight distribution and all of that. Her family have caravans, so it's a great way. It's a great thing to do, but you do need. It's not like having a trailer at the back of the car.
It's amazing how often you see. Obviously, not as dramatic as that, but when you're on highways, how often you do see a caravan start to jackknife slightly.
Yeah, because it's scary, obviously, for those in the caravan, but for those around, you see that hurtling around. I mean, if you're travelling near that.
And it sounds like you go completely against your instincts, which would be to brake when that fishtailing starts, but the only way you can get out of it is to accelerate.
Yeah, yeah.
Fascinating. Or to stay in a hotel. Or go on a cruise, like that other couple earlier.
Or go on a cruise.
With the horn bags.